Hi guys, this is Ekta from Studio Bodhi and welcome back to our YouTube channel. Now the last few months have been extremely challenging for parents across the world with the schools being shut and kids sitting at home, unfortunately because of COVID-19. Being a mother myself, I completely relate to the challenges that most parents are feeling today on how do we keep our kids constructively busy at home in a happy way. So in the last few months, I have been resorting to a lot of art and craft activities with my kids. And in today's video, I will be doing a quick tutorial on one such activity which I have been doing a lot with my kids, which is stone or rock painting. Now, this is a very easy activity which you could do with kids at home, and it can be done with kids across all ages, but I would recommend it for kids 3 years plus with minimal adult supervision. So let's get the video started. So before we actually start the artwork, let's have a quick look at the art supplies needed to do this artwork. So the first thing that you will need for this artwork is obviously a stone or a rock. Now, this is actually a rock which my kids have picked up just from the playground or the park nearby. And I would assume that most play areas would have some form of a stone or rock lying around, which you can just pick up. Make sure it's cleaned and as dirt or germ free and dried fully before you use it. Now, two, three things that you need to keep in mind before selecting a rock. One is that it needs to be a flat surface for you to paint. Approximately this size or more, and most importantly, if you're doing this with younger kids, then it should have no sharp edges because that could be dangerous and could hurt your kids. Secondly, a clean palette to put your paints in. Again, a small plastic clean palette would do. A bowl of clean water, any container which is lying around at home and is clean and not used for any other purpose can be used for this. A clean cloth, which is very important when you're working with young kids, as they will mess up and you need to often clean your brushes. So a cloth which is not being used for any other reason, is a waste cloth, can be used for this purpose. An important part of this, gesso. Now, since we are going to be using acrylic paints to do the rock painting or the stone painting, we will apply a coat of gesso. Gesso is basically a primer which is applied as a first coat or a base coat before we actually start putting acrylic paint. This ensures that the output will have a great finish. And now this is a most commonly available product in most art stores across the world. And if you're only going to be using this one time, then I suggest you buy the smallest bottle available. Next, a set of acrylic paints. Now, these are the paints I have with me and I've been using this for a long time. And if you are going to be buying a set of paints, I would suggest buy a small set. This is a graduate variety, but if you're again only using this with kids and only for rock painting, you could even pick up the student variety. Anything that's not too expensive and works for the purpose. Next, important part, a set of brushes. Again, because you're using it for kids, I would not recommend something very expensive, but you would need probably one or two flat brushes, maybe one or two round tip brushes, and of one or two sizes, so maybe a small one and a big and a medium size one. And again, if you're planning to do a little more detailed and fine work, then maybe even a fine tip brush like this. Lastly, if you are planning to keep these rocks or stones as memories of your kids' artwork, then I would highly recommend that you also pick up a small bottle of varnish. Varnish is basically a transparent polish that you would put on your finished output over the acrylic paint. Now, this basically ensures that the paint doesn't peel off in the long run and doesn't get scratched or damaged. So if you want to keep these rock artworks as little souvenirs for your kids' childhood years, then I would suggest that you apply a bit of polish at the end so that the paint remains intact and there is no damage in it. So before we actually start painting, I just wanted to take a quick minute to introduce the little artist who's going to be our chief artist for our artwork today. Now, since this is an art video for kids, we thought why not have a kid actually doing the artwork. So this is Anaya. She's my 10-year-old daughter and she loves art. And she's going to actually do the rock painting today. Anaya, are you excited to be a part of the video?
Yes.
And are you looking forward to painting?
Yes.
So should we get started?
Yes.
So the first step in the rock painting is to actually apply gesso primer as the base before we can actually put acrylic paints on it. And we will do this using a flat brush like this one. And you can just use the flat brush and very gently apply the primer on the stone. Now, typically, you will need 1 to 2 coats of gesso before the stone is ready to be painted with acrylic paints. And you need to make sure that between each coat of gesso, you have to give it some time before the previous coat dries, before you put the next coat. So we have finished 2 coats of the primer on the stone, and this is what the stone would look like. As you can see, it's fully white and you really can't see the stone underneath. And the next step now is to actually either do the drawing on the stone directly, or you could paint with paints directly. Now, our little artist here has decided to do a peach color as a base color for this. And so that's what we would be doing as the next step, to paint a base acrylic color on the stone. So we have finally finished painting the base of the stone with this peach or light orange color. And the next step is to now start painting or drawing on this. Now we have decided to draw out a pattern and to trace it out on the stone, which we have done using this tracing paper. And this is the tracing paper that we have used, a yellow color. And using the tracing paper, we have traced this design which we had drawn out on a paper. So the next step for us is to actually start painting this design. So we have finally finished painting our stone, and this is what our stone looks like. As you can see, there's a slight shine on the stone, and that's because we have gone ahead and actually put a coat of varnish on it as well. This is just to make sure that the acrylic artwork on the stone is sealed and does not get damaged. The varnish that we have used is this gloss varnish, which is a transparent varnish, and you can apply it using a simple flat brush. So this is what our acrylic stone painting looks like. It's done and it's got a beautiful shine on it, and it's ready to be used. So this was a small, simple and quick tutorial on how to paint stones or rocks. And I hope you liked watching this video. And I hope after this video, you're able to paint some beautiful stones or rocks with your kids. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and press the like button. And do leave your comments on what video or tutorials you'd like to see next. Till our next video, happy painting.